Well, back in Skegg, end of April 23. This time we're stopped in a hired caravan and not in our own, which, as you may know, we sold last year due to running costs. But anyway, we decided we'd have a couple of weeks down here just before the May Day weekend. So we just decided to have a walk down what's known as Chip Man Alley. A little bit quiet at this fish and chip restaurant to open. Quite a few shops down here. Some have changed since we were here last year. But there's still a nice variety. It's known as Chip Pan Alley, I think, because at one time there were lots and lots of fish and chip restaurants down here. I think there's probably about two or three now. I'm not, I've just lost count. I think there's three actually. Pet shop there, where you can get your pet supplies. Takeaway there. One or two places is still shuttered up because the season hasn't properly started yet. This is a good shop if you like to look in clothes shops. Quite a good selection in here. Not very expensive. And we've got the Harris Amusement Arcade. I've noticed quite a few phone shops up and down these days. At one time you never used to see as many, but they're starting to appear. This is a good shop for your pet. Different harnesses and leads. I'm sure this used to be a car spares shop.
It used to be car auto.
You could buy car accessories.
Yeah.
His place on the left, which is run by the church. You get the cheapest teas and bun anywhere in Skegness. The ubiquitous entertainment exchange there. Epstons, fish and chips. Unfortunately, we never bothered with this fish shop. They're rather expensive. There's Epton's fish and chip shop. We didn't go in this, it was closed anyway, but they're rather expensive. I think it was £10.75 for fish and chips. The name factory, your t-shirt or your hat or any garment printed out with anything you want. Another mobile phone shop on the right there. Quite a narrow street this, and sometimes when there's traffic coming towards you, you've got to be very careful. This shop has been here some years and it looks like now it's up for sale. You can get various high-vis jackets and other things in this shop. Nice little coffee bars, little cafes. Another phone shop. Now this butcher's shop here, this one, Kirk's, is probably one of the finest butcher's shops you can ever come across. The pies are absolutely out of this world, are on a different level. And Elizabeth decided we'd have a steak pie for our tea. I think she said a little over £5, but boy, what a pie. Worth every penny. And quite big as well. And absolutely full of lean steak chunks. Unbelievable. They were absolutely delicious. With the accompaniment of peas, carrots and potatoes. They were absolutely unbelievable. Now we're just making our way to this this mini market just round the corner here. It was a little bit on the quiet side when we called on this occasion. And most of the small shops were shuttered over. And we did not call here at the weekend, so they could have been all open by them. Not too sure. You know, the rent and rates on some of these places can be rather expensive, and it puts people off from opening these little shops.
Nicely done. Yeah, a lot of work involved with them, you know.
We actually just passed a stall where a woman was displaying all the small clothing for babies, so hand knitted things, and absolutely incredible quality. I just wish I'd have filmed that.
Nice patterns on them as well.
Skegness working men's glove. They've had many a happy hour in that place.
Where are you going?
Now we're back into the so-called chip pan alley. This shop on the right used to be Wilkinson's last year, but now that's closed up and been taken over by this other shop.
Well, no more Wilkinson's.
Disappointed in that, because Wilkinson's store was such a nice shop. We used to go in quite regular. It seems that lots of Wilkinson's are closing down all over Britain. I don't know why, because every time I've been in a Wilkinson's store, there's always been plenty of people in.
Curtis's.
This is another one that's closed down, which was a favourite of ours, Curtis's. Lovely bakery that was. A nice shop. Sometimes Elizabeth calls in there. Well, this was interesting. Little and large. And I think Little took the command here.
Yeah.
since at Big Dog I'm the boss, you'll get out of my way. And that's the Hildred Centre behind the dogs, and where this mobility scooter's just coming out of. We're now going to make our way to the other side of the road and have a look in the lovely shopping place. Just first been up the street to get some items in one of the shop what Elizabeth wanted. So we're making our way back down now to the lovely shopping centre. Do people sit outside enjoying coffee and whatever? And we're just into the shopping plaza, as it's called. It used to be a large store, did this. Which closed a couple of years ago now, or it could be a bit longer, and it's all been converted into small shops and areas.
The garden centre, yeah.
There's a nice garden centre. There's a nice model of an eagle. There's certainly quite a variety in this.
It's a lovely garden centre, is this?
Everything you want to. From garden gnomes to, as we've just seen, a large eagle.
Yeah, it looks like Woodthorpe, a branch of Woodthorpe.
Wind chimes. It's an interesting item. It's almost too hot to touch, is that? Yeah, very nice section is this.
Yankee candles, Elizabeth, your favourite.
These are like a magnet to Elizabeth, Yankee candles. Quite an impressive area upstairs. There's a huge variety of items for sale, although we didn't go up on this occasion. They're very smart shops. As we got further around, I noticed one or two of the places were empty, and last time we visited, these were occupied.
Produce and stuff.
Seems to be the norm at the moment. Now we see a lot of beds. Another one blanked off. And a couple of areas blanked off. And I believe this is a discount food store. Ah, I've seen her somewhere before.
The big difference. I don't.
This used to be like an art gallery, this section, but been taken over by this food store.
Never went before.
There's also a lift to go up to the floor above, as I mentioned earlier, where there's a huge variety of items. Electronics, DIY, clothing, bedding, you name it, everything's up there.
Right.
Elizabeth just reminded me to get my feet out of the way. If not, she normally runs over.
Walk down to the front now then.
I'm just going to make our way now down to the seafront. Fish and chip shop on the left there. Just further on, there's the trawler's catch with the pirate theme, cannons firing and pirates giving you the dialogue of what pirates do. It's a busy crossing, is this probably one of the busiest in Skegness. There's the jolly fisherman fountain there, no water running on this day. That in the distance is the climbing feature where you can make your way up to the top and then drop down the other side on a line, but it doesn't seem to do a right lot. You don't see a right lot of people using that, even at the height of summer. Whether it's because it's so expensive, I don't know. I think somebody said it's about £30 a go. It could put people off if that's true. It certainly made a nice job of this area since modernising it, relaying all the groundwork, all these nice patterns, new benches where you can sit down. The vintage fair in the distance on the right.
Comes to different colours as well.
Yeah, we will, Harry. We'll come back.
The riverboat. Quite a few people about, even though it was low season, and it wasn't particularly warm. A sneaky cool breeze blowing, and it could really chill you if you didn't wrap up well. Tower there for the mock lighthouse for the boating lake. And now we're just approaching the area where you can get your fish and chips and lots of other stuff. I would say this is, this place is probably where you can get the best fish and chips in Skegness. Absolutely amazing. It's like everything else, they've gone up in price. Fish and chips are no longer a cheap meal. I'm old enough to remember when you can get 4 penny worth of chips. That's old pennies, probably about equal to 2 pence these days.
Paraglider up there, look.
Now we're just going to make our way down to the seafront. Well, I've heard in recent reports that Skegness is being voted one of the worst seaside resorts there is to visit, and it's been stated that the beaches are not very clean. All the years we've been going to Skegness, I've never seen the beaches strewn in litter. They've always been clean, and if there has been litter at height of the season, they're always clean, and the next morning you come onto the beach, everything's been cleaned up anyway. I don't know who these people are that keep saying it's a scruffy place. If it's so bad, why is it always packed out in summer? Or bank holidays, or even just at weekends, it's always busy. If it were that bad, people would not come. We're just making our way down to the little lifeguard hut. It was a beautiful sunny day, but it was bitterly cold, and the wind was howling. This is an interesting thing about this pathway down to the beach. It's forever full of sand or water. If you get a rainstorm or anything, it's a lake down here, and you cannot get past people with crutches, wheelchairs, mobility scooters, or even on foot. It's tricky getting past it. It's always flooded, and if it's not flooded with water, it's piled up with wind-blown sand. It's in a slight hollow. It just dips down slightly, and I can never understand why the council have never just leveled it off with some tarmac. It's always the same, and many a time over the years when we've been down here trying to get to the beach, we just haven't been able to get past with Elizabeth's mobility scooter. You just can't get through. I'm just taking a walk up the steps, the lifeguard hut. Very efficient down here with the lifeguards in Skegness. It's well maintained, and especially in the height of summer, there's plenty of lifeguards about, plenty of flags indicating safe areas where you can bathe and areas where it's advised not to bathe because of strong currents. They're always always vigilant. They're forever patrolling up and down the beach, keeping an eye on swimmers. Very, very efficient they are. And in the distance, the wind farm. Tide well out on this particular day. beach to ourselves. It on his way back now for that short visit. We'll now make our way to the arcade where the coffee point is. It's our favourite watering hole. And just make a quick walk on the front. There's the lifeboat station of the RNLI. Nice variety of ice creams on here. Prices to suit everyone. They're rather expensive, some of these ice creams, but I must admit they're well worth the money. There's a huge variety. Never seen such a variety of ice creams ever. Well, it was quite cool. It did not stop people. It didn't stop people from enjoying themselves on the beach. Now we've got to the end of the walk on the seafront, and there on the right is the Skegness Pier, the various outside entertainment. There's the main Skegness Pier Entertainment Centre. You get a meal in there, play games, arcades, ideal for the kids. I'm glad in one way about one thing. There used to be an annoying tannoy outside. It used to blare out at one of the games, and it really used to be irritating. And thank goodness they've taken it off. Pleasure Beach. On this particular day, there were quite a large amount of motorcycles in this area. It's rare for motorcyclists, and being an ex-biker, it's mouth-watering for me to see some of these bikes. I love riding my motorcycles in the 60s and 70s. On our way to the Lucky Strike, where the coffee point is, which is our favourite watering hole. There's McDonald's, busy as usual. There's the plaza, which has just had a facelift. Plaza Amusements. Just pausing here to have a look at the water show. People riding around, getting themselves wet. Quite popular is this ride. Well, we're at the other side of the road now. Heading for Lucky Strike. The seafood cafe, that's quite a popular little cafe. We sometimes call there for a coffee. Nice seafood, by the way. There's the Embassy Theatre, the other side of the road. There we are, approaching the Lucky Strike. Near the clock tower in the distance. I think this is one of the best places to get a coffee in Skegness. Pleasant surroundings. You can also get some decent food as well. Some nice sandwiches. While taking this video in this area, I realised that you're not supposed to take pictures or video in the building. I realised it till later when we were going. I've been coming in here for years and never realised that you're not supposed to be taking pictures or video. I don't know why, what the reason is. It must be something to do with the security. But anyway, it was a bit too late really, so hence the video. Now this lift must be rated as one of the slowest in the world. You seem to wait forever, and it's only a couple of floors that it goes to, but boy. At last we've got in the lift and are on the first floor now, hopefully, yep. In the holiday periods, it's absolutely chaotic in this area. You can't move. Same downstairs and above for where the eating area is. It's usually packed out. And there's the escalator, which obviously we couldn't use with Elizabeth on her mobility scooter. You can actually sit on the outside area overlooking the main road at the coffee point. Order placed and the number placed on the table so that they know where we're sitting. Yeah, look at the menu. Quite an extensive menu. Quite a good variety of snacks and meals. All freshly made. Not really overpriced. It's a very popular meeting place, is the Coffee Point. Excellent coffee and tea and food. Also, they've got the daily papers, so you can sit and enjoy the morning paper while you have your coffee. It's very enjoyable and it's a nice atmosphere. Well worth a visit if you're in Skegness. Well, I hope you found this rather long video of use if you plan to visit Skegness. Hope you enjoyed it. Thanks for watching.